Well, it's also a very hard question to answer. Just give me a second.
When
did I know?
When did I realize I was a Lithuanian?
Okay, I'm ready. Are we talking about...
Yeah.
Just answering the question.
Just answer the damn question.
Yes.
When did you first realize you were gay?
Well, I don't know because I didn't remember it. However, my mother said that when I was put in a little playgroup on a roof, that I was so enamored of a young girl who was leading this group that I wouldn't let her take anybody else to the bathroom without me. And then I was madly in love with girls all the way through high school, but the word lesbian had no meaning in any way, and it was a horrible word, but it wasn't me, it didn't mean anything like that. And it wasn't until I got involved in the theater, where everybody's gay, of course, that finally I said, oh, okay, that's me.
The first time I played doctor with my little girlfriend, Playmate. I didn't do anything about it right away, but I knew.
I was all of age 4.
Boy,
I didn't want anything to do with my little boyfriends. They were always wanting to show me their weenies. I wanted to play doctor with my little girlfriends. And that's the story of how it all began.
Somewhere between Gail Storm and Betty Boop, TV was a big influence on me. Betty Boop was hot. And then I was the only girl in a gang of guys in my neighborhood in Queens, and it was really upsetting when my mother told me, you gotta wear a shirt. I couldn't go shirtless anymore. So, at any rate, it was young.
I first realized I was gay when I was 5 years old. I used to sort of pet the elephant in my grandfather's smoking room. And at night I would dream about elephants and little women, little tiny women, who I called my foofy girls. And they were very exciting. They were incredibly erotic.
It's hard to remember when you first realized that you're gay. I think one of the things was I had my appendix out. I must have been about, six, and something of that sort, maybe 5. At any rate, the one thing I wanted was blue jeans. Blue jeans came in just about that period, and I was quite sick, and my appendix burst, and my mother promised me that she would get me a pair of men's blue jeans. And sure enough, she did, and there I was, off. But the other thing I remember was when I was in Garrison Forest in a private school. And I described, how can you be so stupid? I described to my mother my feelings for this very attractive classmate of mine. And she looked at me and she said, those are the feelings of a lesbian. And I thought, well, that's it.
When I was 5 years old, I wrote on a piece of paper, this is who I love. And I listed Susan, Ramin, and a few other little girls, and then I felt this horrible flush of guilt, and I didn't want anyone to see the piece of paper, but someone found it, and they actually started to read it, and I grabbed the paper away and hoped that nobody would see it.
Honestly, I have to say that I first realized I was a lesbian when I was in first grade. And, you know, I know a lot of little girls have crushes on their teachers and stuff, and I guess I have traditional crush on my teacher, but I remember going as far as finding a piece of cardboard that my father's shirt used to get wrapped in and writing a love letter to my first grade teacher. And I knew enough that I hid it and put it in the closet. And I went back years later to find it, and it was gone, so my mother must have found it. But I truly remember having, like, not only, like, feelings of, like, love, but, like, whatever sexual feelings are at 6, like, having clearly different feelings. And thinking back, that was the first time I think I realized I was a lesbian.
It's craft paper, and I opened it, it was like my family, you know, and so, you know, and that's what some, and you opened it up, and on this side there was a clipping from a magazine that said Mom and Dad, and they're over here on the left, and then there's one of my brother, and then there's a picture of a little girl that says Lorraine. I have no idea who Lorraine was, but clearly I thought she needed to be part of my family.
I think it happened to me when I was about 11 or 12, and I had these dreams. And kids that were in orchestra with me that were happened to be girls, I was having these dreams that were like, whoa, you shouldn't be having these dreams. You know, obviously nobody's going to know. I'm not going to like say anything when I go to orchestra. You know, I'm just going to like play and everything will be normal. But anyway, I pretty much knew from my dreams.
So when did I first realize I was gay? Was it when I was 4 years old and got my little cowgirl outfit, which I was adorable. No, that wasn't it. Was it when the Irish woman next door used to call me Laddie? Gave me an idea, perhaps, that I was not quite like the other little girls on the block who I used to play kissing games with. Well, there's a memory that just popped in. Was it when I had a crush on a girl in high school? Oh, that was painful. That was when I was getting a clue. I really knew when the genie was out of the bottle by the time I was 28. You'd think, you know, from 4 to 28, I could have figured it out sooner, but, you know, when you bloom slowly, it doesn't mean you don't bloom. Just took a while.
It was 1964 in Flushing, Queens. My best friend was Diane Hamill, and we decided that we needed to practice kissing so when we were with boys, we would know what to do. We were 13 years old. We started practicing kissing. I think I liked it probably a whole lot more than she did because there was a light bulb with a little string. We were in our basement, and I kept on turning the light off, and then she'd turn the light on, and then I'd turn the light off, and turn it on, and so on and so forth. And that's when I first knew.
When I was a little girl, my mother called me a bulldagger, and I didn't know what it meant. To me, it was a knife to kill bulls with. And I was called a tomboy, and that made no sense to me. I know that my earliest, they weren't crushes. I had friends that I just needed to spend a lot of time with. And I realized there was something different going on when I was in junior high school and the girls that I was spending time with wanted to do with boys what I wanted to do with them. That's pretty much what it was, that's as much as I knew. And I didn't actually come out until I was 17, which to me was way too late.
I was 12 years old. I was having a sleepover with my friend Norma Wilkins. And we were lying there perfectly, properly. She on her side, we were in a double bed, me on the other. And just lying there, thinking about her and how she looked like Linda, well, there was an actress that she looked just like. I can't remember her name. And I had an orgasm lying there all by myself. Wow. Hands off, so help me.
Wow.
So then I figured out the next day.
In 1952, when I was 14 years old and going back to my lovely girls' English boarding school for the first day of term in September, and I'd been there when I was 12. I got there when I was 12, and the first thing the girls said to me was, "Who are you going to have a crush on?" And I remember thinking, great! And here we were, 2 years later, and I got back from my holidays, and I got back to school, and all my classmates brought out photographs of uniformly ugly men with whom they were in love all of a sudden. And I thought, oh shit, because I graduated to the head girl. And
I was 14, you know, and I knew there was something awfully wrong with me at that point because I was not happy about this. And I went to ground. I didn't tell anyone a soul about who I was or how I felt for the next 10 years. It was about the loneliest, miserablest 10 years I had. And as you can see, I'm still here and I got over it.
I first realized I was gay in the 7th grade at PS 108 when I found myself wanting to be with Diane Hofberg for the entire lunch hour instead of playing handball against the boys, and we just like kissed for like 45 minutes in a row, and then I thought my lips were going to fall off by the time I got to my classes, that everybody in the whole school knew that something was wrong with me, but it was fascinating.
Because I remember being like 5 years old and on the swing and thinking that I was a boy and being surprised, and it was like, oh, I guess I'm not. Okay, all right, I can get that yet. Okay.
I never was interested in boys, and I didn't know what that was called. I mean, as a kid, I just was interested in playing with the boys, playing sports, and not interested. I remember girls on my block had closets filled with clothes, and I found that bizarre. I couldn't understand why that was so interesting. But by the time I guess I got to be 15, 16, and you know, and the hormones are supposedly running rampant, well, they weren't exactly running rampant in my body, I noticed that everybody was very interested in boys, and I couldn't have cared less. And it was probably a year or so later then, I don't even think I had a name for it, but I definitely started to have serious crushes. And I think the most serious one was when I was 21, I think, with a woman who was in college with me. And she actually kind of led me on and then rejected my advances. Wait, this is a wonderful story. And that put my lesbian life probably back 3 or 4 years. Well, about 20-odd years later, I was playing softball from the South Shore playing the North Fork, and a woman stood in front of me and looked at me, and I looked at her, and I looked at her, and she looked at me. I knew I was supposed to know her, but I had no idea. She told me, I'm going to let cats out of the bag here, she was Joanne Schellenbach, who used to be Joanne Spinner. And I certainly didn't recognize her, and she took the opportunity to tell me how sorry she was that what I had done was just scare her to death. And in fact, it's quite clear that she turned out to be as much a dyke as I was. That's my story.
The first time I found out that I was gay, I was working with a boyfriend at 17, and a woman whistled at me. And I felt something that I never felt in my life before, and pursued it, and here I am.
I'm pretty sure it was the night that I went to a date with a boy who was on the basketball team, and they were in the locker room changing, and I was in the back seat of the car necking with another girl. We were double dating, no doubt in my mind. Took a long time to fulfill that, but that was about it.
I didn't figure it out for a while. I remember as a senior in high school walking through the school, through this main yard we have, this main road, really, and thinking, gee, isn't that interesting? I haven't had a crush on a boy this whole time. I, of course, was badly in love with my best friend, and I was really close to one of the high school cheerleaders, who I'm not sure to this day if she ever came out. And then I went to college locally being in California, and met some lesbians. Well, they didn't say they were lesbians, but met some women and had a boyfriend, in quotes, who was actually a gay man. He was coming out, I was coming out, so we couldn't talk about these things. And eventually I met someone and we had sex, and I went, okay, this is it.
In February of 1972, I went to Yellow Springs, Ohio to a lesbian conference. There were 200 lesbians there, including the Furies from Washington, D.C. And so, it's a shock to see a lot of lesbians. That changed my life. I stopped doing what I was doing and went on the road and went to all these lesbian conferences. So here I am today.
always thought when I was growing up that I would be a boy, that I was a boy. And so it was always, it was a big surprise when suddenly I started to develop breasts and have my period. I was much later than anyone else, and it was a bit of a shock. I had a crush, a girl in high school, but I was also dating, and, you know, I thought about lesbianism, and I thought, gosh, if this is what I am, I'm going to commit suicide. So at that point, in high school, I didn't act on any feelings at all. When I went to college, dropped out, came back, and then began to have feelings for a coworker, another woman, and we decided to move to New York. And I was definitely going to New York to become a lesbian. That's what it was. I think I was 21 or 22. I did act on it. I had two affairs, neither one of which was particularly happy. And I thought to myself, if this is what it is, I don't want any part of it. So for many years, I was not gay. I was heterosexual. And in my late 40s, feelings began to come up for women. And I finally decided, I can't ignore this. This is just so much a part of me. I came out to Orient one summer, friends out here, and I decided to see what the women's community was like. And luckily, I met my partner for life, Frederica, and I've been very happy with our relationship and very happy with my sexuality. And I'm thrilled.
I'm married at 19. I didn't last long. And eventually I realized that I was doing more men than women. So it was an overwhelming number. And then I decided I should switch.
Okay.
That's the story.
Okay.
Because I used to go to Brazil a lot and the women were gorgeous. That's about it.
Lithuanians. Let's see.
Joe, remember getting married?
Was I with you yet?
No. You were going to get married to Joe. And a little bit before that, you thought...
No, stop! You guys stop.
You thought, I'm making a big mistake. And you went to, this is what you told me, a psychiatrist.
Isn't it nice to have friends?
And the psychiatrist said, don't be silly. You're a good-looking woman. Lots of people don't want to get married.
This is true. I'm glad Venetia's here to help me out on this issue. Yes.
So she got married to John. They both turned out to be gay. How can you do that?
Isn't that amazing? Yes, we were both gay in that.
She made a bigger impression on me than she does on herself.
Thank you very much.
I think... if I had paid attention, I would say that I was all very young myself, because I remember having wild crushes on all of my two brothers' girlfriends. So I think I was pretty young also. But I went on to get married, so I didn't really be completely aware of it until I was my late 20s.
When did I know? We moved from Brooklyn, New York, out to a little country town in New Jersey, and about 2 years later my best friend approached me, who was a woman, a girl. We were kids, and I thought, well, this is interesting. And then I realized she had an older sister who was in the Air Force, and Kay would come home with her girlfriend, and they would take us into the Bagatelle when I think I was about 14. We were drinking in the Bagatelle. It was outrageous. And I remember one night in particular, we were there and we were raided by the cops. I think what had happened was that the owner hadn't paid them off. And they literally lined us up in this dark, dingy room, and they felt us up to see that we were female or male. And I looked what light there was, I looked around the room and I thought, I don't want to be here if this is what being gay is. They didn't arrest any of us, but it was horrendous. So again, living in a small town, I had to have a boyfriend. So I was living a double life for many years. I think probably I was bisexual for a long time,
Because when I left that town, I went to work for an airline back in New York City, and I actually started dating a man again. And it was very unsatisfactory. So I decided I was pretty much straight. But during periods of having relationships, every once in a while I returned to being with a man. And it just didn't work for me. So I guess I knew when I was about 10 or 11, here we are.
I don't remember ever realizing that I was gay. It just sort of happened gradually from whenever, you know, running through the streets of Manhattan with your high tops on and people saying, are you a boy or are you a girl? To getting looked up and down by women on the street, to the first person I slept with, to not being interested in boys, obviously, so I was asexual, of course. I mean, I obviously wasn't interested in sex, and it just took a few times, and it sort of happened. So I never had a realization.
So what I really knew, I guess I was 35 years old. I was a single mom living with my two kids, who were then, let's say, 3 and 5. But it really echoes way back. I'm 15. I have a crush on my high school gym teacher, my best friends in high school, and some of whom I met at my 50th high school reunion. I still have a crush on one of them, Suzanne Panati. But anyway, then there was the friends in college, and when I was in graduate school, not then, I didn't know then that two of my best friends were a couple. They had been a lesbian couple since they were in high school, but even her sister did not know. But later, like in my 30s, my young 30s, most of those folks were all lesbians and live kind of all over. And I've spent a lifetime getting to know them better, getting to know a community here. I guess I always knew in a way, but what I really know is that the lives of women are really important to me, and as my life has evolved, it's part of who I am.
So I went to this gay wedding, all dressed up, kind of like a slutty Marilyn Monroe. And they were dancing, and I started dancing, and all of a sudden, I realized that I wanted to be attractive to the women that were there and not the men for the first time in my entire life. And it was such an incredible sensation. So I guess that was it.
When an art trip to Italy, sleeping in the same bed as my teacher, a woman, for 2 weeks, that certainly did it. And then suddenly at 55, it all was very clear. Wish I'd gone on a trip when I was 10.
She got big red lips, she got big brown eyes, and she treats me right. It's a big surprise, she won't do anything that she said she would. She makes me feel good, she makes me feel good. I ask her, come here, baby, she tells me no, no. I ask her, drive me here, she said, drive your own. She likes to race my motor and slam my hood. She makes me feel good, she makes me feel good. When the angels look down from above, they see a very special love. How she makes me do what no one could. She makes me feel good, she makes me feel good. So buddy, if you're feeling down and down, your girlfriend treats you bad too, man. Just remember what she's bound to do. She make you feel good, she make you feel good. She got big red lips, she got big brown eyes, and she treats me right. It's a big surprise, she won't do anything that she said she would. She makes me feel good, she makes me feel good. She makes me feel good, she makes me feel good. She makes me feel good, she makes me feel good. She makes me feel good, she makes me feel good. She makes me feel good. Thank you. big red lips, she got big brown eyes, she treats me right. It's a big surprise, she won't do anything that she said she would. She makes me feel good, she makes me feel good, she makes me feel good, she makes me feel good.